7 through 10. It says, just because of the excess of the revelations, therefore, that I might not feel overly exalted, there was given me a thorn in the flesh, an angel of Satan to keep slapping me, that I might not be overly exalted. In this behalf, I three times entreated the Lord that it might depart from me. And yet he really said to me, my undeserved kindness is sufficient for you, for my power is being made perfect in weakness. Most gladly, therefore, will I rather boast as respects my weaknesses, that the power of the Christ may, like a tent, remain over me? Therefore, I take pleasure in weaknesses, in insults, in cases of need, in persecutions and difficulties for Christ. For when I am weak, I am powerful. Now, you notice there it talks about the thorn in the flesh. And as you might understand, we don't know exactly what that is, but it could be in a physical way. It could have been his poor eyesight. But did you understand why Paul wanted a cure? Was it for himself because he was in pain or because he was in distress? No, because he felt that this was hindering his service to God. So he was thinking that if this was removed, he would be able to do so much more. But yet, how did Jehovah respond? Did he remove that physical ailment? No, in verse 9, he said, my undeserved kindness is sufficient for you. So here's the point. If Jehovah was so concerned about the amount of our activity, or the amount of Paul's activity, wouldn't he have removed this thorn from him? But he didn't. And why is that? Because what he could do, or what Paul could do with the strength that he had, is what was pleasing to God. Look at Hebrews chapter 13, verses 15 and 16. Hebrews chapter 13, and verses 15 and 16. It says, through him, let us always offer to God a sacrifice of praise, that is the fruit of lips which make public declaration to his name. Moreover, do not forget the doing of good and the sharing of things with others, for with such sacrifices, God is well pleased. So what is God well pleased with? With our making public declaration. Now, in any of these two scriptures or accounts, did you notice that you needed X amount of hours? Or did you need it to preach and teach like you used to preach and teach? No. See, we are just like Paul. We might face physical limitations. We may not be able to do the things we used to do. But see, if that was so important to Jehovah, he would remove our physical limitations right now. But why is he well pleased? He is pleased because you are doing the very best that you can. So what does this mean? Well, Satan wants us to get to feel that, well, you know those 15-minute increments, the 30 minutes that you have now that you're up in years and you're physically up, it's not really worth anything. So no sense even turning in. That's what Satan wants us to feel. He wants us to feel discouraged. But rather, from what we read in the scriptures, is just how Jehovah feels? No, he is well pleased when we are doing our best. So you notice the pleasing of God is not dependent on our physical health. So even if there are times that we might feel weak, or even pioneers might look, wow, I've been pioneering for 20, 30, 40 years. You know, when I first started, in my first 5 years, I always pushed myself. I always could power through it. And then we start to think something's wrong with us because 20, 30, 40 years later, we cannot do that. Well, this is distressing to us. Because it's in our mind. But understanding how Jehovah views our service, his perspective of things, helps us to understand how Jehovah thinks. So don't allow Satan to discourage us, even when we face physical health. Our third area of discouragement, and this is the same discouragement that David felt. Look at the 40th Psalm and verse 12. Psalm 40 and verse 12. There's this, for calamities encircled me until there's no numbering of them. More errors of mine overtook me than I was able to see. They became more numerous than the hairs of my head. Well, there's no doubt we are sinners. There are no doubts we make mistakes. But sometimes what happens, and this is where Satan tries to get his foot into our lives and discourage us, is to feel that if we made a mistake, that's it. And see, generally, we start crushing ourselves about it. Just like the psalmist says, more errors of mine overtook me than I was able to see. Isn't that what usually happens to us when we become discouraged? See, maybe it starts with one past mistake, and the next thing you know, in the second grade, I remember I took this pencil and I cannot believe it. Next thing you know, every error in our past life comes up, and then how do we start to feel? Discouraged. We start to feel unworthy. Well, again, it's important to see things how Jehovah sees them. Look at Acts chapter 3 and verse 19. Now, if we are truly repentant, we turn around, we make it our aim to not keep making the same mistake, how does Jehovah view our sins? Let's look at Acts chapter 3 verse 19. It says, repent, therefore, and turn around so as to get your sins blotted out, that seasons of refreshing may come from the person of Jehovah. So if we are repentant, and we turn around, and we are dedicated to not repeating the same sin, we're still sinners. But how does Jehovah view this? It says, your sins blotted out, as if he no longer sees them. That's how we looks at. See, maybe to illustrate this, maybe we're writing a letter to someone.